honor our needs. So a man has to develop the art of honoring his needs and being open to discomfort and telling Kare, I love myself enough ki even if I am rejected, I can go ahead, you know. Even in marketing, for example, most of the people have a problem with asking for a big price. You know, why? Because you might get rejected, you might lose the customer. All of this is about mastering discomfort. If you master discomfort, and you can actually raise your price the way you want, you know. And some people ask me during the prosperity seminar, okay, how can I charge so much and all, it is not a fair price. My definition is any price which is acceptable to the buyer and the seller is a fair price. I might sell you in $1,000, I might sell it in $1,500, no problem. I can't afford to have guilt. If this is acceptable in this, if this is acceptable here, both is okay, both is a fair price. But do I have the vulnerability to come up and say that this is my price? And am I open that I'll be rejected and I'll be made a fool of and I'll be ridiculed in the market? No problem. If I'm open for that, then the joy is also going to come through the same gate. The gifts of life are also going to come from the same gate. You get this? So honoring our needs, honoring how we look at things is very, very, very important. And that's a sure shot sign of being an authentic person. Most of us who are into spirituality have gotten it wrong and we have gotten into suppressing our needs in the name of let go. You know, in the name of vairagya, in the name of non-doing and flowing with things and everything. Then the whole world will take you for granted. So can you be a person who honors his needs and at the same time keeps on giving, giving, giving? You know, both the things together. My giving cannot come at the cost of my receiving because it's a circle. If I don't receive, how am I going to give? If I have to offer, I have to be rejuvenated first, you know. If I am not rejuvenated, how am I going to offer? You know, if I am not my best self, how am I going to be compassionate and do any seva also? So I have to honor my needs, I have to honor my personality, I have to honor myself the way I am, I have to ask for favors, I have to ask for whatever it is that rejuvenates me, and from that space I keep offering. This is authenticity. And not pollute it with anything, you know. So even in expression, so in the philosophy of radical honesty, you give it with the emotion. Don't let your emotion be suppressed. And I'm not saying it won't backfire, it can backfire. So what to do?
Accept it.
Be with it. Be with it. And be in authentic listening also. Because that person might have a... And you know what is the other advantage by being, by operating this way in relationships? You know, when you open up,
the other person
also gets a chance to open up. You don't understand that. If I am goody-goody, and I don't open up, well, that person has to be goody-goody, you know. How is that person going to come up with his feelings? Maybe he is not in sadhana, he doesn't have enough guts also to open up. So I am in sadhana, I open up, then he gets a chance to express back and open up. Then we know what is going on in each other's minds, otherwise I am with my story, you are with your story, then pura zindagi nikal gaya. Andar andar hi apna story chal raha hai dono ka. This is not communion, it is just co-living. You know, co-living and communion, they are two different things. Two independent islands living together, you know. That is not community, that is not communion. When I let myself be seen with all my anger, you let yourself be seen with all your anger, displeasures, love, vulnerabilities, inclinations, kinks, whatever it is, you know. That is where intimacy can happen, no? Otherwise, there is no intimacy. At the most, there is some harmony. Harmony is somewhere and intimacy is somewhere. There are different poles, you know. So with spirituality, maybe we can all come from discord and hatred to harmony. But when we open ourselves up with courage, vulnerability, honoring our needs, only then we can move from harmony to intimacy.